His name was Arthur Robinson, just 17 years of age, when he went to fight the Kaiser, Britannia's war to wage. Off on a grand adventure he thought, like the heroes of which he'd read, they'd be back in time for Christmas dinner, for the tea and gingerbread. But now he sits in trenches dark and damp, writing letters they'll never see, eating rats they catch on bayonets and drinking beer gone green. The officers talk in hushed tones of battles won and lost, of how they gained 10 yards a push, but never of the cost. Now our Arthur was sent on patrol one day, when he saw, nestled in a tree, a great black raven beckoning to him in between the branches three. Arthur cautiously approached the bird, as it swooped down on the ground, and it took the shape of the alder cane in a dark and misty crown. The alder cane offered him a deal. He smelled the fear in Arthur's breath, that Arthur would survive the war if he pledged his soul upon death. And our Arthur thought of his hearth and home, of his family, and of France. And he accepted the alder cane's deal and gave his middle finger as advance. On his way back from patrol that day, Arthur passed the German camp. He saw a priest giving mass, and the soldiers looked askance. He saw one out there too, not with the rest, and he saw Arthur too. They locked their eyes and raised their guns, neither knew what to do. Arthur saw that the German boy, no older than himself, was too missing his middle finger, and his face knew fear itself. They both trembled there with hope and fear, not knowing the path to take, and they both squeezed their iron triggers, and the alder cane with laughter quaked.